All right, good evening. It's about 10 to 9 p.m. Yep. We just got done with ministry at TPO on Tower Avenue. Yep. I got Brother Pastor Dan Galovich on my right here. And we just kind of left a meeting. We had a great teaching by our Brother Jesse Heller. And afterward, just kind of led into some organic prayer, naturally, I mean, about just praying for our nation, praying for the leaders of this nation, and also praying for our brothers and sisters in Christ to make a stand, right? To make a stand in humility, but also in boldness, and to make a stand not for our own selves, not for our agenda, but to make a stand for truth and righteousness. And one of those things is making a stand for life, right? So we want to make a stand for what God says to make a stand for. So,
amen. You know, God, these are challenging times. They're going to be challenging times for the body of Christ. We need to be a voice. We need to be a voice out there in the wilderness. We need to be a voice crying in the wilderness, standing up for the unborn. That's one of the major issues today. We have to be a voice as a church and just be bold. I just want to encourage everyone to be bold and do whatever it takes. Do whatever it takes in the name of Jesus. And fear not. Fear not. Because we can be a voice together.
That's right. One of the things that came up is we were talking about sometimes, I'm not saying all times, but sometimes Christians may not speak up because of what other people think or what man thinks instead of the holy fear of what God thinks. And so a person may pose a question to us about a certain topic. What do you believe about this or what do you believe about that? That's like a slow pitch in softball, right? That's the perfect time to make a stand for God and what God says. It's like somebody lining up a ball, if you're a ball player, right down in the middle of the plate, nice fastball. That's the time to hit that home run, and to, so to speak. So when somebody asks you, yeah, we can say things in humility and love, but also we can make a stand for the truth. And so we just encourage you, you know, I believe it's 2 Timothy 1:7, that God hasn't given us a spirit of fear. The enemy wants to bring fear, intimidate, and discourage us. But God has given us a spirit of power, love, and of that sound mind. So let's come alongside each other, encourage each other, and to be an example. Amen.
Yes, amen. Absolutely, we need to come alongside one another, be an example, and not fear what comes, because there's going to be work to do in the body of Christ today, and we need to stick together and fight this battle. Because the battle is being waged in heaven. It's being waged in the spirit realm, and we're a part of that. And so let's just stand firm and believe God for what He's going to do next in our lives, if you're not.
Amen.
Amen.
There's a verse that we want to maybe finish with. It says, when you've done all you can do to stand, stand. Don't go backwards.
Absolutely.
You know, Jesse Heller shared this evening, there's enemies we have, the flesh, the devil, and the world. So there's enemies, but we have the armor of God, we have the Holy Spirit within us, and we have the spirit of truth, and we have God's word. Amen.
Amen.
All right, y'all have a good night. God bless.